Hello, my name is Sebbi, and welcome back to the Coffee Break in Minecraft. Today is Sunday, February 14th, 2016, and so today is Valentine's Day. In case you have missed it and you are in a relationship, it's probably too late to organize something in order to surprise your partner, but maybe the introduction into this episode of the Coffee Break was a wake-up call for you to remind you of the Valentine's Day, and so you are now running around like a headless chicken in order to get something organized to surprise your partner. But yeah, you're welcome. I'm glad that I have rescued your life and that you are now able to enjoy the Valentine's Day with your partner. And well, if you're not in a relationship, just enjoy your Sunday. It's hopefully a beautiful Sunday wherever you are. And so yeah, happy Sunday. Okay, enough of that, enough of this craziness. So what else? We got some gravity waves. Wow, that's amazing. That's really, really amazing. On September 14th, 2015, scientists measured some gravity waves. That's so fantastic, as it confirms Einstein's general theory of relativity. And so, wow, this is really a great finding. This is really a great result. And yeah, I'm probably not the best person to really explain what it's all about, and my examples are probably not the best ones, but still, I will try my very best in order to explain this great phenomenon to you. And so I think today I will not build that much, as I have to focus on what I'm talking and what I'm telling you, and it's really complex to explain all of that, and I don't want to get distracted by figuring out how I have to place a block so that things are looking good. And okay, don't stop stalling, just start explaining. So what are gravitational waves? Well, I hope you all have heard about this analogy of, gravity is basically the spent sheet of fabric, and if you place something on that fabric, it will sink a little bit in depending on its mass. So if you place a heavy ball on that fabric, it will sink in very deeply, whereas if you just place a feather or something light on the fabric, it will the hole that is created by that object isn't that large. And this is more or less exactly what is going on in our universe. So planets are creating some holes in the fabric sheet of our universe. Oh dear, that's really a bad example, but I hope it will make things a little bit clearer. And depending on the mass of the planet, the hole is deeper, and this is also called the gravity well. So if you want to do some interplanetary travel, for instance, you have to overcome the gravity well, and so you need a lot of energy to really reach the, well, to climb out of that gravity well. And for our Earth, the gravity well has a certain size, and for the Sun, a star, the gravity well is even larger. And if you then go for a supermassive black hole, then you have really, really a deep gravity well. And this is the first idea of having gravity, or of trying to explain what gravity is. And in the end, our universe is a span sheet of fabric or so. Oh dear. You have those holes, those gravity wells, and now I need to focus for a brief moment on the actual gameplay. And normally it's nothing is going on, but there is the theory, the theory is now more or less proven, that if you have really, really heavy objects, and by heavy objects I mean a bag of cement or so, I mean I mean super massive or black holes or super massive stars or things like that, and they move really really fast, or they orbit each other really really fast, they will lose some of their energy by, or well, some of their energy will be transformed into gravitational waves, and those waves move then through the sheet of fabric of our universe, and they bend a little bit space and time. And this is really a complex and a mind-boggling thing. It's really hard to really wrap your head around the whole idea that, all right, if an object moves really really fast and it's not generating heat or so, or some other type of energy. No, this time it's... Dang it, I can't make that jump. That's bad. I want to chop down all those trees for no reason. Maybe I need a lot of wood, or I need just something to do while I'm talking to you. And, oh well. Okay, no, I'm lost. So, it's not heat or so. In this case, their energy is transformed into gravity waves, and that's really fantastic. And on September 14th, scientists measured an event that took place. Let me just check my notes. That took place 1.3 billion years ago. So this is really a long time ago. And at that point, two black holes collided or merged, and at first they were spinning really really fast around each other, and were of course creating some gravity waves. But the exact moment of the collision and the moment that both black holes merged released a lot of energy. So the theory is that was proven by those measurements is that if you have two black holes and they collide, they will not have the mass of both of them. Instead, they will lose some of their mass, and this mass that is lost is... Dang it. And the mass that is lost is transmuted into gravity waves, and that's cool. And so this is what was measured on September 14th, and that's fantastic. That's really fantastic because, as I said, it proves Einstein's general theory of relativity. And here now, it's the question how to measure gravity waves. I mean, if we want to measure temperature, then we just measure the temperature by seeing if the temperature is increasing. And okay, this is already a complex example, and so we do have tools to measure those things, but how to measure something that bends space and time? Well, for this purpose, they built several observatories, because in order to really prove that the measurements are accurate and that it was indeed a valid measurement, they have to have several of those observatories to really make sure that this event really took place and that it was not an error or so. And in general, the observatories are L-shaped, not buildings, but L-shaped tunnels or so. Each arm of the L has a length of 4 kilometers, and inside those tunnels are some tubes. Have I noted this somewhere? No. There are two L-shaped... There are two arms in L-shaped formation. Of a length of 4 kilometers, and inside there are some tubes, and they are in near vacuum, and they shoot some laser beams through those tubes. And as the speed of light is a constant, you can also use the light or the laser beam in order to measure the distances. And what they do is they measure the distances between two mirrors in order to to see if the distance is changing. And this was the case that the distance has changed a tiny bit, and this is how they found out that, or okay, there just grew a new tree. All right, so I can chop that tree down right away. This happened, and so then they figured out, all right, this might have been the collision of two black holes, and the gravity waves we have measured were the result of the collision, and as those two black holes merged and released some of their mass as gravitational waves, and those waves move through the universe. And by being able to measure them, we get a better understanding of the universe itself as, I got a lot of wood. That's fantastic. So much wood, so much building material for my my bridge. And I got so many new saplings. That's also fantastic. So I continue to grow my wheat tree farm. That's great. Oh, speaking of growing things, I wanted to start a wheat farm at some point, but I don't think that I like to do it today. Oh, the furnace is still going strong, that's good. So I think I need a lot of more of those things. So, okay, I can store it just there. I have really a lot of materials, and yeah, at some point I like to build some supports for my bridge, but probably not today. No, I just like to go to bed. And by being able to measure those gravity waves, we can learn a lot of more about the universe by, we can see things going on we weren't able to see before, such as the collision of two black holes. And that's fantastic. That's really amazing. And, there's a creeper. And so, wow. That's really fantastic. That's really a great outcome. And I wanted to explain a little bit more how this whole observatory works. It's called the LIGO, I guess. I noted it's the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, observatory, and it's called LIGO. And as I said, they have 4 kilometer lengths long tubes, and they shoot laser beams to this. And by measuring the time the laser beam needs in order to travel from one point to the other point, they can determine if the length has changed. And this happens if, the space is being bent by a gravitational wave. So if you're on top of the wave, everything is a little bit elongated. And if you're more or less on the valley, the space shrinks down a bit. And so the time the laser beam needs changes a little bit. And this is the way how we can measure a gravitational wave. And that's really a great concept. And now they are also thinking about watching stars and looking into the universe from Earth is all right. We can build large telescopes and so on in order to look into the sky. But we have always to deal with the atmosphere, and the atmosphere is causing some issues. And I'm not quite sure if there are, I should have researched this a little bit more, but the same thing is also for gravitational waves, that there is the chance that being on Earth reduces a little bit the effects maybe, and so having a space or having an observatory in space could really enhance the outcome of those measurements. And in this case, I think they are also thinking about launching some kind of space-based observatory, but I'm not quite sure if they, when and how and if and so on. Currently they are still working on the new space telescope, and it's still very expensive, and it's not sure if it will really produce the right results. Okay, now we are out of fuel or fire, that's alright, because now I can begin my journey to my mine to grab some lever and to continue on talking about this, as yeah, it's a really a complex thing, and I think thinking about how to place blocks could be a little bit problematic and will just confuse me while I'm talking about all those things. And yeah, so well, I think now as I begin my journey to my mine, I'm out of topics, I have finished this, but well, I still need some fresh levers, so I still have to do this. And yeah, so much about this. What else? On Friday was my usual running day. In most of the cases, I'm running before breakfast, so I get up and then I go running, and afterwards I enjoy my breakfast. It just tastes better after you were running and you have a great start into the day. And yeah, on Friday it was not really cool. I think we had outside temperatures of around 1 centigrade or so, so it was really good, but as I was out, it started to snow. At first was just some small little snowflakes, not very frequent, but over time the amount of snow increased, and towards the end I was, yeah, really running in... Okay, what are those chicken doing? Okay, this chicken is a little bit trapped in there, and chickens in there... well, natural environment or so. Interesting, very interesting. So, I was running and a lot of snow. It was really crazy. As I got back home, I needed at first to shake all my clothes to get rid of all that snow that has accumulated on my body. And this was funny. And but as I was done with my breakfast and I looked out of the window, the sun was shining, so well done. Right in the moment as I was out running, we had heavy snow, and as I was back inside and I had to do other things like working on those presentations, the sun came out, and yeah, this was funny, but is there anything else I have to... Can I leave something here? No, not really. So I just have to store my horse somewhere. I think I will do this up here at my tower. And is there anything else I wanted to discuss? This whole gravity wave thing, really. Well, I thought, okay, I will talk a lot about this, and well, moreover, nothing happened during the last few days. I was constantly working on those presentations, and I haven't watched a new movie, and they're in the movie theater, so there's nothing much to talk about a movie or so. Is there maybe something else I can discuss? Let me think. Was something else going on? Oh dear. I don't think so. I don't think so. Oh dear. That's really bad. I started this, well, not long journey, but I started to travel over here to my mine to be able to talk about things. And now, as I'm here, I'm lost as... Alright. And now I'm lost, and I'm not quite sure what I should talk about, and that's bad. I think I should return to the mountain home and maybe build or work a little bit on a few rooms. I remember one thing. I like to try out if carpet looks nice on the floor of this very huge room I built with that glass wall, and I think I worked on that room in the last episode, and yeah, I like to see if carpets look nice, or if this looks strange. So I need some carpet. I think I should have some wool left. I just have to see where have I stored my wool and what time is it now. I hope I can get back to the mountain home before the sun sets to end of the episode and to continue working on the mountain in the next episode. So I have some wool, maybe snow wool. How much wool do I need to craft a carpet? 3? No. 2! Okay. So, I will just give it a short try. And in case it looks good, I will return. Or I will grab some more wool. And I do have even my sheep somewhere over there. We can see them down there, are my sheep. So I have plenty of wool available if I need one or if I need some. And all right. Now it's time to return. And what to talk about? That's really problematic if nothing is going on. And why don't you ask a question in the comment section? I need something to talk about. I need something for cases like now that I'm lost. And I learned something new as Promi has commented on the last episode, the Faschingskrapfen episode, that in his region, he is living in Canada, those Krapfen, Berliner, or however you like to call them, are called jelly donuts. That's cool. Maybe I have heard about this term before or so, but at first I thought, most of the time now we have sunset already. Maybe I will stay overnight in my tower. Maybe I will do this. Alright. That's cool. Krapfen are apparently called jelly donuts. Okay, that's fantastic. And it helped me a little bit to bring this episode to a better ending, that I'm not constantly thinking of things or trying to figure out what I can say. Okay, this was fantastic, and we are coming to the end of this episode. So I hope you have really enjoyed this episode of the Coffee Break in Minecraft. I hope it was interesting to listen to my explanation of the gravitational wave situation, and that our universe is a span sheet of fabric, apparently. I hope it was really interesting for you, and I hope you'll like this, and I hope you will be joining me in the next episode. In this case, until next time, my name is Sebbi. See you!